Hey Java developers, JDK 22 will be released today. So let's take a look at the 12 JEPs, the JDK Enhancement Proposals, included in this release. If you're interested in learning more about these JEPs and other changes coming in JDK 22, I've included relevant links in the description, including to a JDK 22 release notes episode I published last week. Lastly, follow this link to get a notification to our JDK 22 launch livestream later today. We'll host interviews with key JDK engineers, demonstrate some new features in JDK 22, and more. Alright, let's get started. There were four final feature JEPs included in JDK 22. JEP 423 added support for region pinning for G1. Basically, when working with JNI, garbage collection need not be disabled during critical regions. JEP 454 finalizes the Foreign Function and Memory API, or FFM API. The FFM API is an improvement over JNI, which addresses many issues with JNI, including in areas of productivity, performance, and platform support. JEP 456 adds unnamed variables and patterns. This JEP allows variables and pattern variables you do not intend to use to be replaced with an underscore. This not only reduces code verbosity, but also improves the intent of code as well. Finally, JEP 458 launch multi-file source code programs, as the name suggests, allows the Java launcher to compile and launch multiple source code files, an improvement over JEP 330 launch single-file source code programs. There were seven preview JEPs included in JDK 22. JEP 447 allows statements to be added before a call to super and constructors. JEP 457 provides a standard API for class files. It's unlikely most developers will interact with this directly, but it will improve the experience of upgrading between JDK versions. JEP 461 introduces stream gatherers. Stream gatherers are an intermediate operation that can be applied to streams to transform elements within that stream. JEP 463, implicitly declared classes and instant main methods, is the second preview of JEP 445, unnamed classes and instance main methods. This comes with rule changes to the implicit declaration of classes in source files and procedures for selecting which main method to call. String templates, structure concurrency, and scope values all enter second preview with JEPs 459, 462, and 464 respectively, all containing either minor or no API changes. Finally, the only incubator is JEP 460, the Vector API, with its seventh iteration of incubator status. The Vector API will continue to remain in incubator status pending the release of Project Valhalla features. Well, that's it for JEPs in JDK 22. See you at the livestream.